Hello! In this video from Ansys How-To series, we will discuss what is interference fit and where is it used, how to set it up in Ansys Mechanical, and how to post-process and interpret the results. Let's go! An interference fit is created when two or more parts have geometric penetration between them. We use contact algorithm to detect this penetration and apply contact forces to push parts apart until there is no more penetration. In this process, the parts may deform, develop compressive stresses, and create a contact pressure between two parts. This contact pressure is often used to establish connection between different parts, called as a press fit or friction fit, where the frictional force between them resists the applied forces. The performance of such joints depend on the tightness of the fit, which is in turn directly dependent on the amount of initial penetration. The same concept is often extended to other modeling applications, such as installation of gaskets and O-rings. So, how to set it up and solve interference fit in Ansys Mechanical? Well, I will show you how to do that. So, here is the model for a pin and a hole. The radius of a hole is 0.49 millimeters and the radius of a pin is 0.5 millimeters, a little larger than that of the hole. So, when the pin is installed in it, an interference fit is created. We can inspect this in geometry in section view. Now, let's set up contact pair for this interference fit. Insert a contact group and insert a contact object for this pair. Pick the contact and target surfaces for the contact pair. The contact and target designations describe two sets of surfaces that may come in contact with each other, where the contact points can't penetrate the target faces. Let us go ahead and pick the surface. In this case, since both the sides have similar material properties and geometry, let us go ahead and pick surface of the pin as a contact and the surface of the hole as the target side. We'll leave the contact behavior to be program controlled so the solver can swap the sides if it deems necessary. By default, the contact type is set to bounded, which implies that there is no relative motion between two surfaces. However, as the interference is resolved, there is a relative motion between the contact and the target surfaces. So, it should be set to one of the nonlinear contacts. In this case, we'll pick a frictional contact and set the coefficient of friction to be 0.2. Now, we would like to set up two contact parameters for interference fit analysis: pinball radius and interface treatment. Insert contact tool to generate initial contact results. From initial information, we can observe that contact is initially closed and that there is a geometric penetration of 0.01 mm, which is the true geometric penetration or geometrically imposed interference. Notice that resulting pinball region by default is bigger than the geometric penetration. Pinball radius should be bigger than the geometric penetration. This is because the solver can detect contact only if both contact and target surfaces are within pinball radius. Now, let us see what change happens to the contact initial information if we reduce the pinball radius to 0.005 millimeters. The contact status changes to open with no interference. If we increase the pinball radius to 0.015 millimeters, which is bigger than the interference, the contact status is closed with interference of 0.01 millimeters. Under contact, there are three options available for interface treatment. This contact parameter defines how the contact interface of the contact pair is treated. The first option, adjust to touch, is used when there is an interference or gap between the surfaces in the geometry that is not intended to be physical. With the add offset ramped effect, the interference is resolved within one full load step, which is recommended for nonlinear large deflection analysis. Setting this option to add offset no ramping, the solver would try to resolve the full interference in only one substep, which may be challenging to solve, especially when nonlinearities are prominent. So, in this case, we'll set this option to add offset ramp effect. Next, we will define analysis settings. Interference fit is usually resolved in the first load step where no other external loads are applied. Any external loads, such as displacements, forces, or pressure loads, should be applied in the following load steps. In this example, we'll define a displacement load to simulate the pin pull out, so we'll use two load steps. It is recommended to turn out the time stepping on, so the interference can be resolved gradually, so the solver can capture any path-dependent behavior and for better numerical convergence. Define the substep for each load step, 25, 10, 100. These numbers are picked such that the solver has enough room to adjust the load increment in case it has trouble with convergence, or conversely, to increase the load if it's easy to converge. Turn on the large deflection as this is a nonlinear simulation. We intend to calculate the contact forces in this case, so set up output controls for extracting contact forces. Go to output controls and turn on the nodal forces to yes. This is needed to extract the force reaction for the contact for post-processing. Everything else is set to program control. Next, let's define boundary conditions. Apply a fixed support to the plate and the displacement boundary condition to the pin. The pin is constrained in XY direction to arrest any rigid body rotation about its axis. It is constrained in Z direction in first load step, but set it to a value of 1.7 mm in the second load step where it is pulled out axially. That completes setup of the model, so let's go ahead and solve it. During the solution, we can monitor the status via solution information. Solver output shows the solver log file along with any warnings or errors. The force and displacement convergence graphs show convergence pattern for each substep and load step. Deformation and stress plots trackers can be inserted to monitor deformation and stress during the solution. These tools help us track both the convergence pattern and the accuracy during the solution process. Once the solution is done, we can post-process results. Insert total deformation and equivalent stress plot. Insert equivalent stress results for the first load step. A maximum equivalent stress of 4,200 MPa is developed in the plate due to press fit. Now, animate the total deformation across all the substeps and load steps
we can see that the surface of the hole is pushed away from the surface of the pin to resolve the interference. Now, we would like to examine the contact results using contact tool. Insert contact pressure, penetration, and frictional stress. Specify the load step for which you would like to check the results. We can see contact status, pressure, penetration, and frictional stress for the first load step. In the first load step, the contact status is ticking and contact is closed. We can see that the contact pressure gradually developed from 0 to about 3000 newtons. This is the first load step as the interference is resolved. This correlates with the contact penetration, which is also increasing in the first load step. It is important to understand that interference is not the same as the penetration. The interference is referred to the overlap in geometry, which is physical, whereas the penetration is numerical adjustment. The contact algorithm is calculating the amount of force necessary to resolve the interference. The solver decreases the interference gradually by internally moving the contact surface. As the interference is ramped, the contact force linearly increases. This force is equal to the contact stiffness times penetration. So, if we keep the stiffness constant, the penetration is increasing, which is exactly what we see in the first load step. Next, we observe that frictional stress in contact is small during the first load step, keeping the pin from sliding during the interference resolution. Insert probe to examine force reaction for the displacement boundary condition. Duplicate force reaction feature and change location method to contact region and scope to the frictional contact. Set the result selection to Z axis to see contact reaction force in Z direction. The reaction force in Z direction due to displacement boundary condition at the onset of load step 2 shows how much force is needed to pull out the pin. It starts to decrease as pin slides out of the hole. Eventually, the reaction force drops to zero. The contact reaction is small in the first load step. The frictional force is keeping the pin from moving during the interference resolution in the first load step. In the second load step, the frictional force is high, so to be able to pull the pin from the hole, the axial force of about 830 newtons would be necessary.
In conclusion, the procedure presented in this video is applicable for most interference fit problems. The key contact settings are to use a nonlinear contact, a big enough pinball radius, select the appropriate interface treatment. Other settings, such as mesh density, loads, and boundary conditions and analysis settings, can be picked similar to other nonlinear finite element analysis. I hope this video answered your questions about how to set up and solve interference fit problem in Ansys. Hope to see you next time on our next topic. Bye for now.